Have you ever had an emotional meltdown when something bad happened to you? Let's be real, we've all had one at some stage in our life. So what emotional responses do we have to stress? Well, the common emotions that people have reported are things like annoyance, anger, rage, apprehension, anxiety, fear, dejection, sadness, and grief. Now, people don't report all of those emotions at the same time. For example, if someone is completing a stressful exam, they're not going to necessarily feel anger and rage along with all of the other emotions. Well, I hope not, otherwise it could mean trouble. But they might have a bit of apprehension and anxiety. So why would we experience these strong negative emotions when we're stressed? It doesn't sound very functional to have to experience these unpleasant emotions. But it turns out they can be useful because they can act as an alarm signal. Why do you think we need an alarm signal when we're experiencing stress? Think about what we mean by stress. Remember, it's something that potentially threatens us and needs some kind of response from us. In a lot of cases, this might be something dangerous. So, the strong emotions we experience in response to stress are a lot like an alarm signal warning us about danger. So these strong negative emotions are warning us that we need to do something about whatever it is in the environment that is making us stressed. Maybe run away from that bear. However, a somewhat paradoxical problem is that these strong emotions can actually interfere with our attention, our memory, our judgment, and our decision making. So strong emotions to stress can alert us to action, but then these emotions can make it difficult for us to act in the appropriate way, particularly with some of the things that produce stress for us nowadays. For example, if you're in an exam, it's really important that you attend to the exam questions and figure out what the questions are asking you. To answer the question well, you'll need to remember the material you've studied and be able to formulate the answer. If you're highly stressed, it's going to be harder to do all of that because of how stress-induced emotions interfere with your attention and your memory.